Have you ever smelled something that's taken you back to a particular memory of something you haven't experienced in years? When you were in school, have you ever had a particular colored folder or binder for a certain class, and that color scheme stayed roughly the same throughout your years in school? If you have, then you might know a little bit of what it's like to have a condition called synesthesia. Synesthesia is a condition dealing with the brain's handling of senses that I personally feel not too many people are familiar with. Today, I'm going to be discussing why this condition hasn't been discovered until roughly 200 years ago, what its forms are and why they are so hard to identify, as well as what it feels like to those who have it. Let's begin with the initial discovery of the condition, credited to Sir Francis Galton, a pioneer in the studies of human intelligence during the late 1800s. According to a study curated by V.S. Ramachandran, a neuroscience professor at the University of California, Sir Galton observed that a percentage of the general population possessed a hereditary condition he deemed synesthesia, which, in essence, is the experience of one sensory stimuli which creates a false experience of another sensory stimuli, which to a person without the condition is completely unrelated. For example, depending on the form of the condition, as well as the individuals themselves, someone with the condition may attribute colors to a particular set of numbers or letters. Synesthesia was regarded as a very rare condition at the time of Francis Galton, nearing one in every 2,000 people, which is 0.05%. Although studies shown by the University of Edinburgh suggest that number may be as high as 4% of the world's population, which is one in 44 people. That is 88 times higher than originally thought. During early development, the neural connections in the brain responsible for sensory perception may link more than the usual amount of nerve endings. This results in multiple senses being connected for that specific individual. Because every case is different, this trait is almost undetectable without knowing what to look for, which is the main reason this discovery hasn't been made earlier. As of this year, there are only two ways to identify synesthesia. One being functional imaging techniques such as MRIs and other brain scanning methods, as well as personal testing, which relies on individual test results. To the naked eye, an individual with this condition is the same as any other. Only their perception of the world around them may be different. As for the different forms of perception, there are 8 broad forms of synesthesia that span across more than our 5 main senses. The most common and most frequently studied is grapheme color synesthesia. This refers to the different perception of colors when a certain letter or number is being read. For example, the alphabet is a visual representation or set of graphemes for the language or languages that you speak. The same goes for the number scale. As for individuals with this form of the condition, the only ways to self-diagnose are to test themselves by reading or to undergo a brain scan. Here's where things can get really interesting. This visual form of synesthesia can be broken down further into 2 types, the stronger of which being referred to as projection grapheme color synesthesia. Individuals with this type of grapheme color synesthesia feel as though the graphemes that they see and the colors that they associate them with exist in the real world. The weaker type, which is referred to as the association type, consists of any particular grapheme being perceived as what it actually is. This means that when an individual with association grapheme color synesthesia reads a black and white document, they perceive it as black and white. But what separates them from the general population is that they have a very strong compulsion to their associations, meaning that if they see a particular grapheme, their mind will tell them that although the color of those graphemes are in black and white, they should be a certain color. and in some cases may even be taken a step further across the boundary of emotion, meaning that a set of numbers, letters, and colors may also have their own personality types, emotions, and even genders associated with them. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. The reason I'm speaking on this form of synesthesia and how I know so much about it is because I myself have this form of grapheme color synesthesia. Here's a little story. I've learned from the age of 5 that when I was in kindergarten, practicing to write in my numbers and letters, as well as coloring them in, I was strongly convinced that they were already filled in with various colors. But little did I know that was just my condition. To this day, I still have the same associations, but of course I know what is what. Many different studies argue that this form of synesthesia is very effective in aiding in memory and learning, which I can personally attest to, because I can easily remember long sequences of numbers and words by relating them to the colors I perceive them as. Overall, I, as well as these studies, view synesthesia as a very interesting condition, to say the least, and in some cases can be very advantageous.